Inhale with Steve Ross.
Hello, we're here. We're going to do some yoga. Stand up. Step the feet apart. Hang forward just for a moment. A quick, quick moment. Relax the neck. Breathe deep through the nose. Let's see if you can celebrate silently today.
Really feel good about somebody. There's nothing wrong being in love with someone, yeah.
So here's what we're going to do. Keep the feet more or less where they are. You may have to move them a little bit. But you want to bend the knees, bring the forearms on the thighs or knees, sinking the butt and chest down toward the floor. Or you can bring the forearms all the way down to the floor, maybe. Planning on visiting any third world countries, or you're going to go camping, this is a very important posture to learn. I don't feel it, so we're going to stay here until I do. I haven't felt it in many years. All right, bring the hands down to the floor, straighten the legs slowly.
Walk away with victory.
Oh, baby. Once is not enough. Come back down. If you want to make it a little easier for some people it makes it harder, you turn the feet out a little bit. Charlie Chaplin style. Then you come down. And bring the hands to the floor, straighten the legs.
Stay out all night long.
Roll all the way up. Now that we've ripped your hips open, we're ready to jump around. Bring the feet together, somehow. Up. Hands together. Inhale. The arms up, drop the head back. Exhale, come all the way forward. Hands down, head up, jump back or step back. Slowly, with the elbows close to the ribs, sink down toward the floor. When you get close, inhale and arch up into the upward facing dog. Arms are straight, legs are straight. Oh, I like this song. That's nice. This is too hard with the legs off the floor. Who's judging that it's too hard? Or bring the legs down if you have to. When you're ready, push back. Down dog. Sink the heels down. You can walk the feet in maybe a little toward the hands. Arms are straight.
Even though we sometimes would not get a thing, we were happy with the joy the day would bring. Sneaking out the back door, hang up with those good love friends of mine. Breathing out the back door, although I thought I told you not to.
Light as you can, jump the feet up to the hands. If you can't jump them, step them up, that's fine. Roll all the way up, stretch up, arch back maybe a little bit. Exhale, come all the way forward. Hands down, head up, jump back or step back. And bring it down. Arch up, up dog. And push back, down dog. Too cold in here, or is it my imagination? Doesn't matter, we'll warm it up. Jump the feet up to the hands. Jump them right back. Come down. Push up, up dog. And back, down dog. Raise the right leg up in the air. Push the left heel down toward the floor. Swing the foot up, crescent pose, straighten the back leg, stay on the ball of the back foot. Some of you aren't grooving enough. And bring the hands down to the floor, step the foot back. Come down, and up, and back, down dog. Left leg up in the air. Swing the foot up into a crescent, other side. Again, back leg straight. Straight as you can get it anyway. I don't believe her. They all say that. They don't mean it. Okay, bring the hands out. Step the foot back. Come all the way down, and push up, up dog, and push back, down dog. Raise the right arm up in the air, turn to the side, try to keep the legs straight, hips up high. If this works for you, great. If it's too much, bring the left knee down, support your weight. If you want more, you can raise the right leg up in the air. You can even grab the big toe of the right foot, perhaps. And come down, do a push-up if you're feeling energetic, or just go straight over to the other side if you're not. You could do 20 if you want in between. You have a lot of energy to burn. All right, come down, all the way down. Arch up, up dog. Push back, down dog. Jump, both feet up to the hands, into a chair pose. Arms up in the air, high as you can get them. Legs bent. And bring the hands down, straighten the legs. Roll all the way up, stretch up, arch back a little bit maybe. And then exhale and come all the way forward. Just hang down and relax for a second. We'll be right back. Stay tuned. Don't leave. Stay tuned to inhale. We're back. Roll all the way up. Stretch up. Arch back a little bit. Exhale. Come all the way forward. Hands down, head up, jump back or step back. Bring it down. And push up, up dog. And push back, down dog. Raise the right leg up in the air. Keep the right leg just like it is, slow as you can. Bend the arms and sink down toward the floor. When you get real close with the chest, you can drop the leg down and arch up. That's fun, kind of. Push back. Down dog. Other side, left leg up in the air. Keep the leg high, slowly sink down. Drop the leg and arch up. Uh-huh. Push back. Down dog. Again, right leg up in the air. Swing the foot up. Press and pose. Turn the back foot flat down. Turn to the side. Come into a warrior pose. Right leg bent, pretty much a right angle. Left leg straight. Both feet are very flat. Look out over the right fingertips. Uh-huh. Lift the chest up a little bit. And breathe.
Well, I tell you what. Yeah, I've always wanted to do this.
Me too. We're just going to hold this for a while.
Rapping, so heavy D.
Yes, sir.
I need your help, man.
Gotcha. I got you. Check me out. Hey, your wife won't you like a clock, tick tock, you don't stop.
Blue. Slide the left hand down the back leg, reach back. Keep the right arm straight as you can. Warm it up heavy, warm it up, baby. You can always straighten the front leg if it gets too hard. Otherwise, try to keep it bent at least a little bit. You can ask for a lot, but don't ask for no way. Right hand down to the floor, flat down. Left arm straight up in the air. Keep it calm.
Hey, Lucille, can I get the date for real? I can set you straight.
From here, reach underneath the front leg if you can with the right arm, grabbing the left fingers or hand or wrist behind you. If that's too much, keep the right hand on the floor and just drop the left arm behind you.
Understand. He got the upper hand. After all, he's been fondling you for years.
Yeah, bring the hands down. Step the foot back. Come all the way down.
Get my own guitar.
Arch up. And push back. Down, dog. Left leg up in the air.
Well, here we are, right? Just leave it on in there.
Swing it up. Crescent pose.
Well, I'll feel better if you just keep holding my hand. Even my old lady's getting it. She's starting to feel good here. Lucille didn't know she'd ever do any rapping at all.
Turn the right foot flat down. Warrior, other side. Okay, right hand down the back leg, reach back. Uh-oh. Patrick's got other ideas. Must be in a hurry. Doesn't look painful. Bring the hand down to the floor. Right arm straight up or straight over your head. Either way, keep rolling the right ribs open along with the shoulder. Reach underneath the front leg. Grab a hold.
Keep it coming. Yeah, oh
yeah. Thank you very much. Bring the hands down. Step the foot back. Come on down. And up, up dog. And push back, down dog. Jump both feet up to the hands. Chair pose. Arms up, legs bent. All right, bring the hands down, straighten the legs. Lift the head, jump back or step back. Come on down. And arch up, up dog. And push back, down dog.
Just as you're feeling blue, we'll all be there for you. When the light gone out, and the food grown out.
Jump both feet up to the hands again. This time they'll sit down. Turn this way. Bring the hands down about a foot behind you, fingers pointing toward the feet. If you can, flatten the feet, do that. If not, don't worry about it. If you want to make it easier, bend the legs like that.
Just push up high as you can. But if you're going for the hard one, feet are flat, you push the hips up, chest up, head back. Either one.
All right, come on down. Turn. Cross the legs. Hands down in front of the bent knees. Lean forward. Jump it back and arch up. And push back, down dog. Jump the feet up to the hands. Roll all the way up. Reach up. Go back if you want. You don't have to though. And exhale and come all the way forward. Just hang there. You can roll the weight toward the balls of the feet if you want. We're gonna do more warm-up, yoga style, when we return, which shall be soon. You're watching Oxygen Media. And we're back. Bring the arms up in the air. Bend the legs. Chair pose. Breathe.
Guess you better slow the Mustang down.
And bring the hands down to the floor. Straighten the legs. Lift the head. Jump back or step back.
Guess you better slow the Mustang.
Come on down. And up, up dog. And back, down dog. Raise the right leg up in the air. Swing the foot up. Press and pose. Sing it.
All you want to do is ride around, Sally.
Bring the left hand to the floor, right arm up in the air into a twist. You can bring the hand either to the inside of the foot, or if you're feeling fairly flexible, you can hook the left arm over the front leg. If that doesn't work, you can do the regular prayer variation with the palms together, hooking the left elbow instead. But keep rolling the chest open no matter what you're doing. And keep the back leg straight. You like that warrior thing. And bring the hand down, step the foot back. Come down. Arch up. Push back, down dog. Left leg up in the air. And swing it up into the crescent pose first. Bring the right hand to the floor, left arm up in the air, unless you're more comfortable with the prayer style, in which case go for that. Make sure the feet are fairly wide apart. You can always step the back foot back a little bit farther to get more leverage. Keep rolling the chest open. Whoa, must be time to come down with a hand. Step the foot back. Come all the way down. Arch up, up dog. And push back, down dog. Just stay here. You're starting to lose it. It's a good sign. Jump the feet up to the hands. Jump them right back. Come on down and arch up and push back, down dog. That was so much fun. That's right, we're gonna try it again. You barely tap the feet, you just jump them up and back, okay? So jump them up and jump them back. Come on down, arch up. Push back, down dog. I'll be doing this by myself next week. Raise the left arm up in the air as long as you're feeling warmed up. Turn to the side into the one-armed incline. Pretty much always a nightmare, but especially when you're tired. Doubt if you want to do a push-up in between, so you can always go to the other side. But if you're masochistic, go for it. You can always bring the knee down, support the weight. Still looks cool, but you feel a lot better. And bring the hand down. Make your way down to the floor. Arch up, up dog. Why are you sweating? Push back, down dog. I'm not sweating. Jump the feet up to the hands. Roll all the way up, stretch up. Exhale, come all the way forward. Pull the chest away from the legs, lift the head, inhale, jump back or step back. Come down. And push up into the up dog. Just stay here for a moment. Try to pull the shoulders back and down. You can drop the head back if you want. Take some deep breaths. If you're really tired, you can rest the legs down to the floor if you need to. That time is over. Push back, down dog. Now we'll try this. It may work out, it may not. We'll find out. Raise the right leg up in the air. Once the right leg is up, see if you can pick the left hand off the floor, either out in front of you or out to the side or behind your back. Go slow. If you have to adjust, if you have to drop the leg a little, or if you have to fall, that's okay. That hand. So the right leg is up, the left hand is off. Very cool. Even for a second, looks good. And then bring it all down, foot and the hand. Try the other side. Left leg up in the air. Remember, people are watching. Right hand off the floor. Left leg is high, right hand is off. Again, either in front or to the side or behind you. If you lose it, it's okay. Try it again. It'll be 7 years of bad luck, though, if you do it. All right, bring it down, feet together. Or actually, just down, hands down. Jump both feet up to the hands. Chair pose. Why not? I'm not doing it. And bring the hands down, straighten the legs. Very slowly, roll all the way up and just hang out for a second. Once you are all the way up, interlock the hands. It's called standing head to knee. Grab the top of the left foot, straighten the leg out in front of you, curl the upper body out over it. Do the best you can. Don't pull the leg way up. Just try to keep it level to the floor and curl over. If this is easy, you can drop the head, the forehead toward the knee. That's enough of that. Slowly bring it down. Let's try the other side. Again, interlock the hands. Grab the top of the right foot. Straighten the leg out. Go slow. If you can't grab the foot and straighten the leg, you can grab the back like Patrick is doing, or you can keep the leg bent. It's okay. That's plenty. Bring the foot down, hang all the way forward, and just relax. You can step the feet apart a little bit. If you want to, you can interlock the hands behind your back and drop them over. If you don't want to, just hang down. That's fine. The devil's on his way. And we'll be back for more yoga very soon on Inhale.
Inhale, we'll be back in a moment.
This is a perfect song for this perfect posture, the pigeon. Left leg in front and bent, right leg straight back behind you. Come on down. You don't want to go to either side. You want to stay pretty much right in the middle. If you don't feel it in the back of the butt or the outside of the thigh or right in the hip joint, then aren't you lucky? In that case, you can always pull the foot up higher. Some people like to do the double pigeon instead, like Tracy's doing. So you can have one foot under one knee and one foot over like that. Some people call it the over-under. I just call it unnecessary pain, but you can call it whatever you want. Once you're there, then you come forward. It's the same kind of thing. It isolates one side. You can do it that way if you like.
Thank you.
stay here and breathe. Full pigeon pose back here. That hurts. So don't ask me, I wouldn't try that if I were you. All right, come on up. Let's do the other side. Once you're done stalling, we'll start. Come on down. All right, come on up. Since we're doing that direction, let's go for the cow, happy or otherwise. One knee, let's say the right knee on top, unless it's too late. Move the feet away from the butt a little bit and then just come down as far as you can. How easy this is depends on the flexibility of your hips and how you're built. For example, Patrick is doing the unhappy bull rather than the happy cow because this hurts, because his hips are probably not that open in that direction, although he can dance. So everybody's got something good and something bad. Just stay here, breathe. If you don't feel it, walk the feet out a little bit farther in front of you like that. And then come on up and do the other side. You can spin out or you can do the regular cautious dismount. Your choice. Whee! Come on down once you're there. As long as you're feeling it, you don't have to get into a long, detailed explanation of why everything is doing what. If you just do the pose, you'll feel it. If you don't feel it, then just raise your hand. I'll come over and make you feel it. And then you still won't need a lot of intellectual understanding. You just
feel it and do it that way.
Lovely, isn't it? All right. Come on up.
Find yourself a partner. This is partner kind of music. Once you get with one, whoever it may be, what you do is you bring the, you'll work it out. There's one extra one I'll do, whoever's left over. You bring the soles of the feet together and you come forward if you're on the bottom. If you're on top, you know what to do. You just push them down, but make it gentle. If you're at home and you don't have anybody to push you around, that's okay. You can do it on your own. You can just slowly back the car over yourself, but that's very risky. So better than that, just hang out in it a little longer. If you hold it twice as long, it does the same thing. So if you're by yourself, you just keep holding it when everyone else switches. All right, come on up. Next victim. Same thing, you can stay there. If you're on the bottom again, the soles of the feet are together and you pull them in. If you're on top, massage them or push them down gently. Don't bounce them though, unless there's something about them you don't like. And this is your way of expressing it. Back in a moment. Stay with us. You guys can let go and go lie down. And we're back. Back for the final relaxation. Not of your lifetime, but just of this show. So, hopefully, anyway. So, once you're on your back and you're flat out, nice and relaxed, take a full deep breath. Begin in the lower abdomen. Roll it all the way up to the top, hold it for a moment, and then just let it fall out. As you exhale, relax even more, the mind at least. According to the yogis, the body, there's three bodies you have. the physical body, the gross, dense physical body, the astral body, which is, corresponds to kind of the dream state and the mind, the causal body, which is pure ideas, a little bit above that. Actually, there's four if you count the absolute essence of what you are. But that's not really a body, so they don't count that. So according to that principle, the physical body is made from the astral. In other words, your mind makes your form, not the other way around. Science is always looking in the brain to find the mind. They never will, because the body is in the mind, not the other way around. So the mind is in your toes, in your fingertips, in your whole being. It's not stuck in a little cage in your skull. So when you know that, you can kind of see if you can relax beyond the boundaries of what you have been taught, what you've been conditioned to believe. Because all that is just secondhand knowledge, and it's not really accurate. There's so many different ways to look at it, and yet we always get stuck with the same way. And what they say is absolutely true today, 20 years from now they say, oh no, that's not it. Medicine does that, science does that, it keeps changing, keeps changing. So when you realize that any knowledge that you get from the outside, through the intellect, via secondhand information, is flawed at best, then you start to look inside for your answers. And when that happens, you're a yogi. Until then, you're a sheep. But that's okay. So just relax in what is in this moment. And what is you don't know what is. You relax in not knowing. Otherwise, you get arrogant, thinking you know how it is. Nobody does, but they pretend they do. Keeping the eyes closed, roll slowly to one side. And then, when you're ready, sit up into a comfortable sitting position. Eyes remain closed. Just sit, not knowing anything and not caring. Then you're free. And bring the hands together. And we say, Namaste.